I'm going to show production of PCBs using 3D printed stencil and UV-curable solder mask applied with rubber roller. The process involves exposing the stencil using 3D printer heated bed and UV light, cleaning unexposed solder mask, etching, and drilling. This PCB will be used for a replacement power supply for Toshiba T3200 SXC computer. It must be noted that this method should only be used with PCBs with reasonably low complexity. I start by plotting the PCB design to DXF format. I'm using KiCad for this purpose. I'm opening a Blender template that I attached in the description. It's necessary to have a Import DXF add-on enabled in the Blender preferences. Now I import the DXF file. Now I right-click on the PCB drawing and move it to the PCB drawing collection. The base of the stencil should be generated automatically. I prepared necessary geometry nodes for that purpose. It's possible to adjust the thickness and the margins of the stencil. Now it may be necessary to add some bridges, which will prevent the stencil from falling apart. They can be moved around, rotated, and duplicated. Unfortunately, this is a manual process at current stage. Now I select the entire stencil and export it in STL format. Be sure that selection only option is checked. I import the STL file to 3D slicing software. I'm using Cura. The stencil can be mirrored if needed. I adjusted expansion parameters to make the holes a bit bigger. I also made the printing speed slower. Now the model can be sliced and checked before printing. Make sure that everything looks fine. Now it's time to print the stencil. After printing, it may require some minor post-processing. Before I cut the copper laminate, I prepare eye and respiratory protection. This is CEM1 laminate, which has less fiberglass than FR4 and is quite easy to work with. I score it multiple times with a knife and break it. Now I clean it with abrasive material and alcohol. Now I place the stencil and make a small hinge using a piece of tape. Now I open the stencil. I clean the rubber roller using alcohol. And I place some white UV-curable solder mask. I spread the solder mask using the rubber roller. I close the stencil and carefully pick the board up. I place the board on a heated bed of 3D printer with a temperature of 58 degrees Celsius. I installed a 3-watt UV LED on top of the 3D printer. The curing process should take around 5 to 10 minutes. I placed a test piece to check if the process has completed. After the mask was cured, I moved the UV light very close to the stencil bridges and exposed each of them for additional 15 seconds. Now I remove the stencil and spray it with isopropyl alcohol. The image of the PCB should appear. I remove the unexposed mask. In some places, a bit of pressure may be needed. If there are any bridges, they may be removed with a sharp tool. Unexposed areas can be fixed with a marker. Now I proceed with the etching process. I use 3D printer heated bed to accelerate it. I'm using sodium persulfate as an etchant. After etching is done, I store the etchant in a HDPE bottle for later reuse or taking it for proper disposal in future. Now I drill holes using tungsten carbide drills and a small 3D printed drill press. I sprayed the board with water before drilling to minimize the dust. Make sure to use eye and respiratory protection. Now I need to remove the mask from solder pads. And the board is ready to be populated with components and soldered. This PCB allowed me to replace faulty power supply in a 31-year-old laptop and even made it powerable using USB-C power banks. More details about this laptop are going to be presented in other videos.